Acknowledging the concerns voiced by the public regarding exorbitant school fees leading to increased dropout rates, Minister Kaduchu vowed that the government is to crack down on schools that defy its directives against exorbitant school fees with effect from second term.
I'd like to urge the head teachers to desist from unfair school fees. And these high school fees charges are really keeping learners away from school.
Furthermore, Kaduchu addressed the pressing issue of fire outbreaks in schools, urging head teachers to implement robust security measures to ensure the safety of learners.
Inspectors of our school, let's ensure our community are living in a healthy environment.
Additionally, Kaduchu expressed concern about schools still adhering to the old curriculum, emphasizing the importance of transitioning to updated educational frameworks.
Such schools will disadvantage the learners because, as you have already been told, this very year, 2024, the examination will be based on the new lower secondary curriculum.
The selection exercise for technical and vocational institutions concluded at Ntinda Vocational Institute in Ntinda. Meanwhile, in a bid to improve the quality of education in the country, the Ministry of Education, together with Union Vision Mission, South Korean humanitarian organizations, have constructed a secondary school that will provide affordable and quality education for the less privileged children in Nakawa Division, Kampala. Ronald Balimwezo expressed a concern over the exorbitant school fees charged by the private schools, which has left many parents in debts.
Last year, we are informed by the Ministry of Education that over 1.8 million children start P1. So after 7 years, only 700 sit for PLE exam. And therefore, we lose about 1.18 million people who don't complete primary seven. We are asking ourselves, where are these people? Maybe they run out of schools because of lack of school fees, because of poverty. So we want to make sure that we increase on the school-going children so that we may have an educated community.
Leaders have thanked the South Korean government for extending support to Uganda's education sector.
As you have this rich academic heritage, you totally have yours holistically, a person, so which is very good. But most importantly, the extension of the secondary school. When I came in, they didn't have space for secondary school, and they had
Story compiled by Sharon Nabasirie and Rachel Nachwala for the news.